This will be with Iran's President Hassan Rouhani, and at 4 p.m., Prime Minister Modi will be inaugurating the India-Kyrgyz Business Forum. The business relationship between India and Kyrgyzstan has been looking up for some time. Another interesting aspect that the two countries share is, of course, a student exchange program between India and Kyrgyzstan. This will be one of the bilaterals taking place today between India and Kyrgyzstan. At 5:50 p.m., Prime Minister Modi will be holding his second bilateral, and that will be with the Iranian president. At 5:50 p.m., Prime Minister Modi will be holding his second bilateral meeting for the day. This will be with Jeenbekov, president of Kyrgyzstan. And the meeting between the two leaders will be followed by delegation-level talks. This is expected at 6:30 p.m. Indian Standard Time. Of course, to be followed by signing of documents and exchange of agreements 40 minutes later. And today itself, the Indian Prime Minister will be emplaning for Delhi at 9:30 p.m. IST. It would be interesting to see what finally emerges out of this extended format meeting that's taking place with all SCO leaders. There have been some very interesting developments that have taken place during this SCO summit, where the Indian Prime Minister and the Pakistani Prime Minister came face to face for the first time after the Balakot strike that took place. Remember, it was shortly after the Pulwama attack that India struck on terror camps in Balakot, following which Pakistan had shut its airspace. But Pakistan had finally granted consent for the Indian Prime Minister to pass through the country. And, however, surprisingly, the Indian Prime Minister had rejected flying through Pakistan. He chose instead to fly through Iran and Central Asia using the route via Oman. And through this no-dialogue situation, India has managed to send out a strong message to Pakistan. This is one interesting aspect of the SCO summit. Of course, apart from concerns of global trade, defense and counter-terrorism measures that have been addressed by India, China, Russia and other leading nations at the SCO summit.
Занимая огромное пространство в Евразии, следуя принципам Хартии ШОС и Шанхайскому духу, ШОС может и в будущем стать платформой.
Let's also tell you more about the Shanghai Cooperation Organization. This is a Eurasian Political, Economic and Security Alliance, the creation of which was announced on 15th June 2001 in Shanghai, China, by the leaders of China, Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, Russia, Tajikistan, and Uzbekistan. These were the founding members. India and Pakistan managed to join the SCO in the year 2017, and the original five nations, with the exclusion of Uzbekistan, were previously members of the Shanghai Five Group, founded on 26th of April 1996. Now, since then, the organization has expanded its membership to eight countries. As I mentioned earlier, India and Pakistan joined the SCO as full members on 9th June 2017 at a summit in Kazakhstan. And the heads of state council is the supreme decision-making body in the SCO. It meets once a year and adopts decisions and guidelines on all important matters of the organization. Military exercises are also regularly conducted among members to promote cooperation and coordination against terrorism and other external threats, to maintain regional peace and stability. And criticisms of the SCO also include that it is used by member states to shield each other from international criticism regarding human rights violations. The SCO is widely regarded as the alliance of the East due to its growing centrality in Asia-Pacific and has been the primary security pillar of the region. It is the largest regional organization in the world in terms of geographical coverage and population, covering three-fifths of the Eurasian continent and nearly half of the human population. For more details, let's also go across to our principal diplomatic correspondent, Siddhant Sibbal. who joins me live from Bishkek. He's been continuously bringing us all the latest from Bishkek as the SCO summit kicked off yesterday. Siddhant, tell us more about this extended format meeting that is taking place with all SCO leaders. How significant is this meeting, and what can we expect to emerge out of the extended format?
Well, yes, Akanksha, I'm standing inside the venue of the summit at the media center, and behind me are the screens which are broadcasting the extended format. Basically, extended format means the observer countries, the four observer countries and the dialogue partners. Remember, Afghanistan is one of the observer countries. And in this format, the basic focus is to increase the influence outside the grouping, outside the SCO grouping. This is a very large grouping already, and if we include the dialogue partners and observer countries, a huge grouping can play a major role when it comes to global development, global connectivity, the issues of trade, issues of which are in a sense causing a lot of problems in today's world. But talking about what is expected to happen, we all are now waiting for the statements of the Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi, what he will say. Of course, we know the focus which has been of New Delhi for last few years has been on the issue of terrorism, especially terrorism coming from Pakistan. The Pakistani state continues to aid abet terrorist groups. So that is the big focus, and that is expected to be highlighted at the SCO by the Indian
Prime Minister. Very rightly said, Siddhant, that this has been a highlight at the SCO, as you mentioned that India and Pakistan are not really having a dialogue. That in itself is India's answer to Pakistan. How has this no dialogue situation, even at the SCO, managed to send out a strong message to Pakistan?
Well, a strong message has been sent by New Delhi even before the SCO summit started. WION was the first channel to break this story that there will be no dialogue, no structured meet between both the leaders. In fact, the first press briefing of the current government saw the question being asked by WION, in response to which the official spokesperson said that there will not be any structured dialogue between both the leaders. And in fact, the Pakistani foreign minister late yesterday night spoke to WION and said that there will be no structured meeting between both the leaders. The big question is, will there be a pulicide? As far as if we look at the visuals coming since yesterday night, the gala dinner, the concert, and of course the family photo itself, we saw both the leaders were positioned in such a way that they couldn't in fact meet with each other, but finally they also did not share any pleasantries or interacted with each other. And this has been confirmed by both the sides, the Indian side and the Pakistani side. Right now, even as I speak, the Indian Prime Minister and the Pakistani Prime Minister are present in the same room. Of course, they are sitting away from each other. There are a few leaders sitting, perhaps two leaders sitting between both the Indian and the Pakistani Prime Minister, but a message has been sent when it comes to the issue of terrorism.
Right.
India has a no-nonsense policy. Talks and terror can't go together, and this has been a policy since 2014.
Right, absolutely right, that India's policy has been talks and terror cannot go hand in hand, and India has been sticking to this policy since 2014. They still seem very adamant upon it, and as we can already witness the extremely stiff sort of body language between the heads of state, that is Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi and the Pakistani Prime Minister. This is, of course, becoming quite a highlight at the SCO. Let me also come to the two bilaterals that are going to take place between India and Iran to begin with. This is, of course, coming at a very crucial time, you know, when Iran is facing sanctions and there's been a global crisis when it comes to the oil economy. What can we expect to emerge out of India's bilateral with Iran?
Well, the Iranian bilateral is perhaps the most underrated bilateral in Prime Minister's two-day visit to Kyrgyzstan, but perhaps the most important bilateral, because remember, when it comes to oil import, Iranian oil import, that has been a cause of concern. The Iranian foreign minister was in India in last week, in the second week last month, but the focus of his visit, the focus of the bilateral, this which is expected to happen in few hours from now, will be that New Delhi needs to continue the import of oil, Iranian oil. That will be the focus for the Iranian side. But New Delhi will also be focusing on things like connectivity. Remember, Chabahar is a project which, right, of course, is an answer to Gwadar, but also a project of for connectivity to Central Asia. And talking about Central Asia, the bilateral between the Kyrgyz president will be focusing on connectivity, on defense, and we have seen how the Indian Prime Minister has been focusing on India's side with Central Asia. In the first tenure, we saw the Prime Minister focusing on Act East, but in this tenure, we do expect he will be speaking, he will be making sure and speaking about ties with Central Asian countries, how to grow the ties, especially through connectivity projects, whether it's Chabahar or through various air corridors.
Right, very rightly said that connectivity will also be one important agenda on Prime Minister Narendra Modi's plan, because as you rightly mentioned, that Chabahar will also feature during the bilateral between India and Iran. Coming to his bilateral with the President of Kyrgyzstan, President Jeenbekov, you mentioned connectivity will be an important aspect there. Okay, so as we speak, there's Indian Prime Minister addressing the SCO summit. Let's listen.
एससीओ के कुशल नेतृत्व के लिए राष्ट्रपति Jeenbekov और किर्गिज
Jeenbekov. Я бы хотел поздравить президента Jeenbekov и Киргизскую республику за великолепное лидерство в этом году в ШОС. И я бы хотел всех вас поприветствовать. Для меня очень приятно принять участие на заседании Совета глав государств ШОС. 2 года тому назад Индия стала полным членом ШОС, и мы внесли большой вклад во все мероприятия. Приветствую. Для меня очень приятно принять участие на заседании Совета глав государств ШОС. 2 года тому назад Индия стала полным членом ШОС, и мы внесли большой вклад во все мероприятия ШОС. Для того, чтобы увеличить роль ШОС и доверие со стороны международного сообщества, мы будем и дальше наращивать наше активное участие, и мы, потому что наша цель также объединение всех народов во всем мире вокруг наших благородных целей. И, конечно же, мы не нуждаемся в сближении наших отношений на международном уровне через транспортные коридоры, Ашхабадское согласие, Ашхабад и так далее, а также является большим вкладом в углубление наших связей. Мы также работаем над созданием открытого коридора между Нью-Дели и Мумбаи. И
physical connectivity के साथ साथ people to people संपर्क का महत्व कम नहीं है. हमारी ई पर्यटक वीजा सेवाएं अधिकांश एससीओ देशों के लिए उपलब्ध हैं. मुझे यह घोषणा करते खुशी हो रही है कि भारतीय पर्यटन की वेबसाइट पर शीघ्र ही एससीओ देशों के पर्यटकों की आसानी के लिए रूसी इंटरफेस और रूसी भाषा में 24/7 पर्यटक हेल्पलाइन प्रारंभ होगी. एक्सलेंसी, एससीओ क्षेत्र में स्थिरता और सुरक्षा के लिए शांतिपूर्ण, एकजुट, सुरक्षित और समृद्ध अफगानिस्तान एक महत्वपूर्ण कारक है. हमारा उद्देश्य अफगान लेड, अफगान ओन एंड अफगान कंट्रोल समावेशी शांति प्रक्रिया के लिए सरकार और अफगानिस्तान के लोगों के प्रयासों का समर्थन करना है. हमें खुशी है कि एससीओ अफगानिस्तान कॉन्टेक्ट ग्रुप के फर्दर एक्शन का रोड मैप तैयार हुआ है. एक्सलेंसीज, हम सबका विजन हमारे क्षेत्र में हेल्दी कोऑपरेशन को मजबूत करना है. हेल्थ शब्द के अक्षरों से हमारे सहयोग के लिए एक अच्छा टेम्पलेट बन सकता है. एच फॉर हेल्थ केयर कोऑपरेशन, ई फॉर इकोनॉमिक कोऑपरेशन, ए फॉर अल्टरनेट एनर्जी, L for literature and culture, T for tourism, free society, H for humanitarian cooperation. H for healthcare cooperation, SCO की 2019-2021 के लिए healthcare कार्ययोजना पर हमें जोर देना चाहिए. भारत को टेलीमेडिसिन और मेडिकल टूरिज्म के क्षेत्र में अपने अनुभव साझा करने में खुशी होगी। ई फॉर इकोनॉमिक कोऑपरेशन, आर्थिक सहयोग हमारे लोगों के भविष्य का आधार है। एक पक्षवाद और संरक्षणवाद ने किसी का भला नहीं किया है। हमें विश्व व्यापार संगठन पर केंद्रित एक नियम आधारित, पारदर्शी, भेदभाव रहित, खुली और समावेशी बहुपक्षीय व्यापार प्रणाली की आवश्यकता है। इससे भी सभी सदस्यों, विशेष रूप से विकासशील देशों के हितों को ध्यान में रखा जा सकेगा। भारत एससीओ सदस्यों के सदस्य देशों के बीच आर्थिक गतिविधियों के लिए अनुकूल वातावरण बनाने पर तेजी से काम करने के लिए प्रतिबद्ध है। आज हम महत्वपूर्ण समझौतों पर हस्ताक्षर करने जा रहे हैं। इनसे एससीओ में द्वितीय वित्तीय मामलों में और डिजिटलाइजेशन और आईसीटी में सहयोग मजबूत होगा। ए फॉर अल्टरनेट एनर्जी, जलवायु परिवर्तन से निपटने के लिए भारत की प्रतिबद्धता हमारे दर्शन में निहित है, जो पृथ्वी को माता के रूप में मानते हैं। आज भारत अक्षय ऊर्जा का छठा और सौर ऊर्जा का पांचवा बड़ा उत्पादक है। अंतर्राष्ट्रीय सौर संगठन भारत की संयुक्त पहल है। इसका उद्देश्य और ऊर्जा की लागत कम करने के लिए प्रौद्योगिकी और वित्त जुटाना है। हम इस पहल में एससीओ के देशों को का स्वागत करते हैं और ऊर्जा के वैकल्पिक स्रोतों को विकसित करने में अपना अनुभव साझा करने के लिए तैयार हैं। आज हम एससीओ के अंतर्गत एनवायरमेंट प्रोटेक्शन के लिए वर्ष 2019-21 में सहयोग के कंसेप्ट पेपर पर सहमत हुए हैं। एल फॉर लिटरेचर, हमारे युवाओं को एक दूसरे के साहित्य को यानी लिटरेचर के परिचय हमारे संबंधों को गहराई देगा। एससीओ देशों की भाषा में भारतीय साहित्य की 10 श्रेष्ठ कृतियों का ट्रांसलेशन किया जाएगा। हाल ही में उज्बेकिस्तान के सहयोग से ताशकंद में एससीओ फिल्म फेस्टिवल का सफलतापूर्वक आयोजन किया गया। इसमें मनोरंजक बॉलीवुड और उज्बेकी फिल्मों का समावेश था। लिटरेचर और कल्चर हमारे समाजों को एक सकारात्मक गतिविधि प्रदान करते हैं। खासकर यह हमारे समाज में युवाओं के बीच रेडिकलाइजेशन फैलाने से रोक सकता है। टी फॉर टूरिज्म फ्री सोसाइटी, पिछले रविवार श्रीलंका की अपनी यात्रा के दौरान मैं सेंट एंटनी में के चर्च गया था। वहां मुझे आतंकवाद के उस घिनौने चेहरे का स्मरण हुआ जो हर कहीं कभी भी प्रकट होकर रोज मासूमों की जान लेता है। इस खतरे से निपटने के लिए सभी मानवतावादी ताकतों को अपने अपने संकीर्ण दायरे से निकलकर एकजुट हो जाना चाहिए। आतंकवाद को प्रोत्साहन, समर्थन और वित्त प्रदान करने वाले राष्ट्रों को जिम्मेदार ठहराना जरूरी है। एससीओ सदस्यों को आतंकवाद का सफाया करने के लिए एससीओ रेड्स के तहत सहयोग की पूरी क्षमता का इस्तेमाल करना चाहिए। भारत आतंकवाद से निपटने के लिए एक अंतर्राष्ट्रीय स्तर के सम्मेलन का आह्वान करता है। एच फॉर ह्यूमैनिटेरियन कोऑपरेशन, भारत अपने क्षेत्र में ह्यूमैनिटेरियन कोऑपरेशन में और डिजास्टर में फर्स्ट रिस्पॉन्डर की भूमिका निभाता रहा है। हमें एससीओ देशों के साथ अपने अनुभव और विशेषज्ञता साझा करने में प्रसन्नता होगी। हमें डिजास्टर रेजिलिएंट इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर के विषय पर विशेष ध्यान देना चाहिए। एक्सलेंसी, बिश्केक डिक्लेरेशन का स्वागत सहयोग के लिए उपयोगी ब्लूप्रिंट मैं एक बार फिर से हमारे मेजबान महामहिम राष्ट्रपति जिनमें को धन्यवाद देता हूं। राष्ट्रपति व्लादिमीर पुतिन को अगले वर्ष के लिए एससीओ की अध्यक्षता करने के लिए बधाई देना चाहता हूं और रूसी संघ की सफल अध्यक्षता के लिए भारत के पूर्ण सहयोग का आश्वासन देता हूं। धन्यवाद।
Спасибо большое, уважаемый Нарендра Моди. Слово предоставляется президенту Республики Казахстан Касым-Жомарту Кемелевичу Токаеву.
That's Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi completely hogging the limelight out there at the SCO as he addressed and made some very valid points at the Shanghai Cooperation Organization. He addressed issues of connectivity and people-to-people contact, emphasized on how people-to-people contact could be established, and that India will do its bit by establishing a special helpline for tourists of SCO countries on the Indian tourism website. He further emphasized on how the SCO member nations should strengthen a vision for greater cooperation in the fields of health, economy, terrorism-free society, humanitarian causes, culture, literature, and alternate energy. He also spoke extensively about the need to eradicate terrorism from South Asia. He quoted his visit to Sri Lanka's St. Anthony's Church and spoke about how he witnessed the horrific face of terrorism. He urged SCO member nations to eradicate terrorism and work as a unified team to remove terrorism that has, of course, been emanating from South Asia. On a last note, the Indian Prime Minister thanked President Jeenbakov. He also congratulated Russian President Vladimir Putin to make preparations as the host for the next SCO summit in 2020. Remember, this is the extended format meeting that is taking place. This is indeed a historic moment for India and for the Indian Prime Minister, as we shouldn't forget, this is his first international summit after his re-election, and he indeed grabbed all eyeballs as he addressed a speech at the SCO just a few minutes ago. Not only did he urge the SCO member nations to work towards eradicating terrorism, he also spoke about establishing connectivity and people-to-people contact and strengthening cooperation through fields of health, economy, terrorism-free society, humanitarian causes, culture, literature, and alternate energy. He also urged other member nations to come up with their own indigenous sources of energy.